Ladies and gentlemen, we are back here live at Completely Damaged at Comic-Con. I'm with the one and only. It's
D.D.P.
That's right. Now, for those who don't know, how did you get started in professional wrestling?
I started as a manager back in 1988, and then became a color commentator in, I think it was 89, with Dusty Rhodes at Florida Championship Wrestling. And I did that for 3.5 years, working in the AWA and working in Florida Championship Wrestling. And first 3.5 years, it cost me money to be DDP, you know?
Oh, wow.
And then I got the opportunity to go to World Championship Wrestling. Dusty brought me in there. And they let me manage Scott Hall, which I created that whole look that he came up with, which would later become Razor Ramon, and then the bad guy, Scott Hall. And he'll be the first person to tell you about it, you know, as far as, you know, me helping create that entire look. But him and the Freebirds were who I was managing. But after 5 months, they were like, with the long hair and the wrap and the diamond dolls. It's like, dude, nobody's paying attention to wrestlers.
Yeah.
You know, so they said, what we should have done was put you in a pair of tights and boots and see if you can do this. And they sort of laughed and walked away. And I had 7 months left of my deal.
Oh, wow.
So I was like, you know, I never dreamt of being a manager. Dreamt of being a wrestler. So I had 7 months left of my deal. I went down there and said, I'm going to blow everybody away. I'm going to become a wrestler.
What are some of your highlights of your career from there?
Oh, God, I had so many, man. My whole major part of my career was spent there.
Winning
think
the title, too.
Yeah, well, you know, when you start at 35 and your career takes off at 40, you know.
Takes a toll on your body.
Yeah, but it's so special. You appreciate it so much more than if you're given it at 22.
Yeah.
When you wait to get there and get it at 40, it's a whole different animal. And then, you know, that was 1996. Wrestling was the hottest show on television, cable television.
Yeah.
Top 10 shows, we had 5 of them between WCW and WWF. And long story short, you know, some of the highlights would have been beating Randy Savage at Spring Stampede and the roof blowing off, you know.
Yeah.
And it was taking Diamond Dallas Page, who was on this rocket, like up to the upper stratosphere, you know. And I probably headlined 12 out of 24 pay-per-views after that. And I was awarded the world title in 1999. I was 43 years young, you know, so that was pretty big.
Then you went off to WWF and WWE, feuded with The Undertaker.
Yeah.
What are your favorite memories of that feud?
None.
Oh, yeah, I don't blame you.
None. I like Mark, good guy, but yeah. Feud sucked. It wasn't our thing. Just didn't work at the time.
Yeah.
I enjoyed feuding with Christian, and we had a great time. But most of my when people say to me, you know, what about your career? What do you think of your career? And I'll say, what team did Michael Jordan play for?
Yeah, that's true.
You know, the Bulls or the Wizards?
Yeah.
I mean, I played for WCW, and when it came time for the WWE to put the very best of WCW together, or say the very best of Nitro, they chose me to be the host, you know, so that was pretty cool, too. By the way, it's the second best selling DVD WWE's had in the last 3 years. Pretty cool.
Definitely cool. Now, you're great on the mic, great, great promo guy. Did you learn from anyone, or did you kind of just pick up the mic and just kind of go with it?
No, you learn. You know, you have guys who are your heroes. Like, I thought Jake Roberts was amazing. Dusty Rhodes, Superstar Billy Graham, Captain Lou Albano, Classy Freddie Blassie.
Yeah.
These are all guys I listened to, and I went, wow.
We need managers like that nowadays.
Yeah, we really do. It's a time for that to come back. You know, Jesse Ventura, the guys who could really talk and were believable.
Yeah.
And I took a little piece of all of them and made them Diamond Dallas Page, you know, and plus I was in a nightclub business, you know. I wrote and did all of my own radio, you know, commercials for the air. I did the hot legs contest, you know, even though I had to do the bikini contest and wet t-shirt contest. So I was used to being in front of a crowd. So when I finally got live television, it really wasn't much that different, you know.
Now, DDP Yoga, what got you interested in starting that, and it's been taking off.
DDP Yoga is changing lives on a whole different level. And you should, if you can mix in or make a part of the video, Never Give Up Arthur Inspirational Transformation. We put that video together. I should say the guy who did a movie called Inspired the Movie, which will be out probably 2013, has Arthur's entire journey. And he knows that I'm what inspired him to move forward. And it was my form of yoga, which ain't your mama's yoga. Because DDP wouldn't be caught dead doing yoga the first 42 years of my life. But I needed it, because that's all I could do. So I mixed yoga with rehab, with old school calisthenics, with dynamic resistance, which is the engaging of muscles as you move. Every time you engage a muscle, your heart's got to beat faster to get the blood to the muscle, hence you get in the fat burning zone standing still. So DDP yoga, and the only yoga's like this, only workout that's like this, zero impact, kick-ass cardio, dramatically increase your flexibility and your core strength conditioning. Only workout that is like that. It's the only thing I do. I'm 56 years young. I'm in the best shape of my life. If you go to YouTube or just go to ddpyoga.com and pull up the video, Never Give Up Arthur, you will be blown away, because what he went through, the disabled veteran who's walking on canes for 15 years, 140 pounds overweight, what he goes through, the transformation that you'll see in 10 months will be nothing less than mind-boggling.
Now, if people like myself and others out there watching that want to try DDP Yoga, do they just go to that website?
You go to ddpyoga.com. If you want to invest in yourself, if you want to take the next step, and I broke it down, four different levels to come in. It isn't like, get that, now we're going to sell you 10 other things. It's like, get that and start and see how it changes your life. And also, I just don't give the DVDs with it, a program guide on how to eat on three different levels. You know, how to set goals, a poster that breaks down all of my top 13 moves, but I also give you MP3s so that after you've done the workout and you've known it enough times, I go do it in the park or in your backyard or wherever you want. You can do it anywhere. A mat would be nice, but you don't have to have it. You can do DDP yoga absolutely anywhere. I got over 20 guys in the WWE doing it right now, from Chris Jericho, who just wrestled at WrestleMania against Punk, and a year before that, the doctor said he was done. 3 months of doing DDP yoga, and he'll be the first to tell everyone. 3 months of doing DDP yoga, he was 95% pain-free. He just headlined WrestleMania. He turned Santino, Kane, Foley, Ryder.
Kane, wow.
Kane, yeah, jeez. Believe it or not. You know, I was glad to see the big man doing it. But also Zack Ryder, Daniel Bryan. There's so many of the Ryback, that big beast, Titus. Okay. I mean, these are all guys who are doing it. I got 20 guys in the NFL doing it. I got guys in the NHL doing it now. And it's something that's great for athletes who get beat up at any level.
So now, DDP, people have back pain. Would you recommend DDP yoga as well?
Well, the only reason there is a DDP yoga is because I ruptured my L4 and L5. If you get the camera, it's right here in the lower part of your back. It's the center of the universe. When I ruptured my L4 and L5, that's as low as I could go, and I had to push myself back up. Now, today, cold, this is my flexibility. We're going to go all the way down, bro. All the way down. Now, flexibility is one thing. Being able to stand here cold, not working out, be able to take my foot and put it right in your camera's face and hold that baby there, or bring it out here and hook that foot and have a conversation with you. This is core strength.
That's awesome.
Now, you know, what's DDP yoga good for?
Everything. Everything, basically.
Everything.
Well, DDP, I want to say thank you. It's an honor and a privilege right now to be interviewing you. I appreciate your time. And any last words for your fans out there?
It's been your pleasure.
All right, guys, this is Completely Damaged Action, DDP, RC. You only find that. Bang!